Tadpole here with legendary trainer Tom Herring. You had Jerome LeBanner fighting tonight. Yes. How was his training camp?
He did very well. You know, Jerome is a very busy man. He make a lot of movies and he's famous all over the world, so he's invited all over. But this time he trained very hard. He was about 1.5 months in Amsterdam. And every morning he was sparring with my other top fighters, so he prepared very well.
Who's your next upcoming top fighter?
I have Hesti Kerkes, Raul Katinas, Sergio Lasenko. I have about 15 good A-class fighters. So.
Right. In this sport, you're legendary. You're known throughout the world. You're one of the guys who helped build this sport. Mm-hmm. Where do you feel it's at right now, and where can it go?
Well, I'm happy it is coming up again, because we had a very good peak in the 90s, but then it was in a dip. I don't know, it's the same word in English, yes. But now with Glory doing very well, and the call that we have also in Europe, a big organization, Supercombat, I think the sport is going up again.
Now, in the 90s, you know, since you brought it up, there were guys like Robbie Kamen or Ramon Deckers. Do you think it needs a star like that? That the American audience can grab onto?
No, I think more they need an American star.
Just an American.
Yeah, because we have so many stars in Europe and other countries, and America is a very big country, and I know they're very good athletes, but they have to train more in Europe and to do the system what we do, because they're very strong. America, right. You see now with MMA, but they also good in kickboxing. In the past, we had many, many good fighters. Hey, Mauri Smit, Rick Rufus, Benny Urquidez, many, many. But they leave it a little bit. So I hope, especially that Americans coming up, because then the competition is nicer for everybody, and the people are interesting also.
Who do you think's the three greatest kickboxers of all time?
Of course, Pete Rats, my student for a long time, and Andy Hook is one, and from another legend is, of course, Jerome LeBanner, because he make it from the beginning. These three boys are, I think, the absolute top. But we had many. It is maybe a little shame to say these names, because I called you, we have Rob Kamman, we have Benny Urquidez, an American guy. So there are plenty. We had Gilbert Ballantini. Don't forget Raymond Dekker. Yeah. It's a legend
Diamond
too,
Dekker.
Raymond. He trained his little boy also in my gym, and he fought three times with my boy Gilbert Ballantini, who fought. So there are plenty. There are many athletes.
Now, building a promotion, you know, it could have gone many ways. Like K1 was a big name, but they seem to have faltered, and Glory's upcoming. Do you think the thing that will make it most successful is having an American show?
Yes.
Showing, like, doing many shows in America so they get to watch it and then say, hey, I want to do that, and then they start training.
You know, the mistake they make, I think, in the past, that they did a couple of shows in Las Vegas and other parts, but then they put the top fighters from Europe against American middle-class fighters. And the middle-class fighters get beat, of course, by the top class. So build it up, and there are plenty Americans. Send a couple to my gym, I will tell you they will be top class, because the Americans are strong boys, and I like the institute, the athletes. So it's a matter of time. When good Americans coming, then they love the sport too. I think so.
Who are the who would you consider the top upcoming trainers? Like, if aside from going to your gym, who would you say are the best trainers?
Holland has many good trainers. We have many good gyms.
Anywhere in Holland?
In Holland, there are so many. Of course, we have Hippolyte with Wojanski. Mm-hmm. We have my gym, we have the gym in Arnhem, Fred Royers, who is like you, also commentator for Eurosport, but there's so many. Cor Hemmers was a very good gym, now he stopped with the gym, but his son take over. You know, that is the good thing in Holland, we have so much competitions that the level is going up. It's like football playing, you know, we want to win with our gym, we fight another gym. And that must happen in America too, and then you will see the level going up.
What about having it start at a younger age? You think it's something that they can incorporate into high schools and as a like an elementary sport to build up?
Yeah, of course. They do it in Thailand. In Thailand, you get it on school. And in Holland, we have so many kids training. You know, we have kids, they 12 years, they already have 50 fights. Of course, with protection, but they get ready in the ring. So you have to start like judo, like karate, very small with the kids.
Can you real quickly just tell a little bit about the history about when you went into Thailand, you know, some of the first you know,
I was a Kyokushinkai fighter and English boxing I did. And then in 1972, I make a combination with my kicks and punching. And it was not allowed. The whole Kyokushinkai world, I get problem. They said, you cannot do that Kyokushinkai with boxing gloves. But I like to punch to the faces.
Yeah.
And then we get training and we fight some schools and we win. Then I was in fight to Thailand with my boys, five boys, in 1976.
Who were those boys?
Ron Kuyt, Robbie Schumann, Imro van Hette, Ram Kisoen and Karakus. These five fighters. And we came in Thailand and they beat the hell out of us. We get beaten all in the first and second round. So I send my boys back. Excuse me. I stayed there 3 months. I learned the technique with elbows, knees and clinching. And that time was more Muay Thai. Now it's kickboxing, but that time was Muay Thai. So I come back and we train. And I promise there for the television in Thailand, I will be back and I will beat some Thai boys. And we did after 5 years. But we training very hard. And so I give seminars all over the world, in Canada, America, Brazilië. And then it get more involved and you see the sport get to a high level. That is the history of my Chakuriki style.
There's a... I don't know if it's a rumor or history, but they said that Rob Kamen was the first white man to go into Thailand and win the championship.
No.
The Thai championship belt or whatever.
No. I think it was Peter Smith.
Yeah.
Peter Smith, he died. He's died already. And my boy Rick van der Vatos, he beat Fanta Atapong. Ballantini, for me, he beat Sang Cheng Noi, the champion that time, the deadly kisser, they call him. So I'm not sure who was the first one, but in that time, many Dutch fighters go to Thailand. But our team in Holland was the first team who fought in Thailand, and we beat them up very badly. But we learn. By that we learn.
Real quickly before you go, Glory has a new system, new rules. What do you think of it, and what's your prediction for the tournament?
I tell you, I see it now for the first time. I have a little bit problem with that. Because I tell you honestly, I'm a Muay Thai trainer. 5 rounds, 3 minutes. Five rounds. Now they do 2 rounds, 2 minutes for professionals. But in a tournament, I can understand. But we have to look how it is working. Because many people confused. After 2 rounds, you winner. Do you have to do the third round? But maybe we have to learn this system. Yeah, you never know.
And your prediction for how the tournament's going to end up? A winner?
The winner? I still think that Sam Schild will be the winner. Yes, I think. But you never know. It's a tournament and sport.
I appreciate your time. Thank you.
Okay, very good. Nice to speak with you.